Sigmund Freud was an Austrian neurologist who is perhaps most known as the founder of psychoanalysis. Freud developed a set of therapeutic techniques centered on talk therapy that involved the use of strategies such as transference, free association, and dream interpretation. One day, in retrospect, the years of struggle will strike you as the most beautiful. Being entirely honest with oneself is a good exercise. Most people do not really want freedom, because freedom involves responsibility, and most people are frightened of responsibility. We are never so defenseless against suffering as when we love. Out of your vulnerabilities will come your strength. Where does a thought go when it's forgotten? He that has eyes to see and ears to hear may convince himself that no mortal can keep a secret. If his lips are silent, he chatters with his fingertips. Betrayal oozes out of him at every pore. A woman should soften but not weaken a man. Religious doctrines are all illusions. They do not admit of proof, and no one can be compelled to consider them as true or to believe in them. It is impossible to escape the impression that people commonly use false standards of measurement, that they seek power, success, and wealth for themselves and admire them in others, and that they underestimate what is of true value in life. In so doing, the idea forces itself upon him that religion is comparable to a childhood neurosis, and he is optimistic enough to suppose that mankind will surmount this neurotic phase, just as so many children grow out of their similar neurosis. Everywhere I go, I find a poet has been there before me. In the depths of my heart, I can't help being convinced that my dear fellow men, with a few exceptions, are worthless. Whoever loves becomes humble. Those who love have, so to speak, pawned a part of their narcissism. Immorality, no less than morality, has at all times found support in religion. Unexpressed emotions will never die. They are buried alive and will come forth later in uglier ways. We are never so defenseless against suffering as when we love. From error to error, one discovers the entire truth. A man should not strive to eliminate his complexes, but to get into accord with them. They are legitimately what directs high conduct in the world. Just as no one can be forced into belief, so no one can be forced into unbelief. The virtuous man contents himself with dreaming that which the wicked man does in actual life. The voice of the intellect is a soft one, but it does not rest until it has gained a hearing. Ultimately, after endless rebuffs, it succeeds. This is one of the few points in which one may be optimistic about the future of mankind. The only person with whom you have to compare yourself is you in the past. The mind is like an iceberg. It floats with 1/7 of its bulk above water. The interpretation of dreams is the royal road to a knowledge of the unconscious activities of the mind. Thought is action in rehearsal. Friendship is an art of keeping distance, while love is an art of intimacy. In the small matters, trust the mind. In the large ones, the heart. A layman will no doubt find it hard to understand how pathological disorders of the body and mind can be eliminated by mere words. He will feel that he is being asked to believe in magic. Time spent with cats is never wasted. The first human who hurled an insult instead of a stone was the founder of civilization. The more perfect a person is on the outside, the more demons they have on the inside. Ego is not master in its own house. Love and work, work and love. That is all there is. The conscious mind may be compared to a fountain playing in the sun and falling back into the great subterranean pool of a subconscious from which it rises. Public self is a condition construct of the inner psychological self. We are what we are because we have been what we have been, and what is needed for solving the problems of human life and motives is not more legitimates but more knowledge. Religion is a system of wishful illusions together with a disavowal of reality, such as we find nowhere else but in a state of blissful hallucinatory confusion. Religion's 11th commandment is thou shalt not question. Religion is an illusion, and it derives its strength from the fact that it falls in with our instinctual desires. It is that we are never so defenseless against suffering as when we love, never so helplessly unhappy as when we have lost our love object or its love. He does not believe that does not live according to his belief. The behavior of a human being in sexual matters is often a prototype for the whole of his other modes of reaction in life. Where the questions of religion are concerned, people are guilty of every possible kind of insincerity and intellectual misdemeanor. America is a mistake, a giant mistake. Neurotics complain of their illness, but they make the most of it, and when it comes to taking it away from them, they will defend it like a lioness her young. Beauty has no obvious use, nor is there any clear cultural necessity for it. Yet civilization could not do without it. My love is something valuable to me which I ought not to throw away without reflection. Intention that man should be happy is not in the plan of creation. Men are more moral than they think and far more immoral than they can imagine. Love and work are the cornerstones of our humanness. The creative writer does the same as the child at play. He creates a world of fantasy which he takes very seriously. Which quote do you like the most? Share your opinion in the comments. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to subscribe to Beautiful Minds so you don't miss any of the best quotes in history. See you soon.